Sanjay Dongre of UTI Mutual Fund is here with us on the show. Sanjay, thanks very much for taking out the time. Let's talk about positioning yourself in any particular sectors that you like or any particular stocks that you're finding value in currently.
So my tilt is always towards the growth, and therefore I always look at the sectors which are likely to deliver the earnings growth in the next 2 years, which is higher than the earnings growth of the market. So from that perspective, when I look at various sectors, I think the sectors where the earnings growth is going to get delivered will be mostly the domestic oriented sectors, and there again particularly it would be corporate oriented private sector banks, then you some of the NBFCs, and then it could be cement sector, then capital goods sectors, or construction, engineering. I mean, these are the sectors where I think the earnings growth is likely to get delivered much higher than what the market earnings growth is. So these are the sectors where I would like to have the positive outlook from the next 2 years perspective.
2 years perspective, and you want to start purchasing them from current levels onwards, or you'll probably wait for a slight bit of a dip to come in post this big run-up that we've seen over the last few days?
Yeah, so the volatility is a part of the equity market. So after the market has run up 8% in the 2 years, obviously you would expect some kind of correction. That is what we are witnessing. But ultimately, the market in the medium term is a slave of earnings, and the market valuations will move towards the sectors and stocks where the earnings get delivered. So that's where currently I'm positioned. My funds are positioned in those sectors.
Hi, Sanjay. Good afternoon. What are the cash levels that you guys are sitting on right now?
No, so as a fund house, we don't take cash calls. So for example, in my funds, the cash which would be there in my funds would be about 2-3%.
Okay, and are you looking at deploying it currently at current levels after the rally has taken place, or what's the current strategy at the fund house is what we want to know?
No, so as far as my funds are concerned, obviously I'm looking at the sector which I mentioned where the earnings growth are likely to get delivered, and there if I find correction in the valuations of those sectors, maybe I would like to move some funds from defensive sectors to the sectors where the earnings growth is likely to get delivered.
Do you expect some bit of sector rotation from sectors, let's say from IT, pharma, which could see profit booking and money could be flowing into beaten down counters for the likes of autos maybe?
Yeah, as I said, the volatility is a part of equity market, and therefore you will find as the earnings get delivered over next 1 or 2 years, you will find some shift happening from the sectors, defensive sectors, to the sectors where the earnings growth is getting delivered. I mean, so that's a part and parcel of the equity markets. Actually, money moves where the growth is, where the there is a possibility of the valuations moving up.
All right. So let me ask you this. Where is their valuation discomfort according to you? Obviously, we've seen much of the move getting priced into consumption. We've seen IT being favorites, and they've started to get pushed towards the upper band in terms of the valuation move. Do you see a correction coming about in any of these names as high beta starts to make alpha into the portfolio? Or do you feel that, you know, these stocks are bellwether stocks, good to have in the portfolio, so if you're paying a few multiples more, it's fine?
Yeah, so for example, if you look at the announcement from the Government of India about the reduction in the corporate taxes, obviously it is going to give short-term bumps in the earnings. And when you look at the higher valuations vis-a-vis the jump in the earnings, what we are going to witness in FY20 or 21, I think the in terms of multiple, the valuations have remained at the same level. So I don't think things are going to be anyway different going forward. So the value, the, as I'm saying, wherever the earnings growth is going to get delivered, the funds are going to move to those sectors.